Good morning children, welcome back to our English class. So in the previous previous class we have started with our chapter 2, Prakash the Peacock. So we have discussed earlier that what is our national bird and what it eats and what is the tail of the peacock called. So our national bird is peacock and the tail is called the train. The tail of the peacock is called the train, and the tail, it spreads its feathers like a fan, and it contains up to 175 feathers, and the peacock eats the grains and vegetables. Okay, and if you observe, when it rains, it dances very beautifully, and the colors of its feathers are pigmented brown, blue, turquoise and green shades. Okay, so now once again we will recall the story of this peacock. Name is Prakash. In this story, the peacock name is Prakash, who is very shy to dance in front of all. Once again we will recall our lesson. That is, we have done a little part of it. Now the rest little part we will continue in this class. Now, so the peacock is our national bird. It is one of the most beautiful birds in the world. Peacocks are known to fan their colorful tails open and dance before it rains. So peacock is our national bird, and its colorful tail opens before it rains. So it opens its feathers when it rains. This is a story of about a peacock called Prakash, who was too shy to dance in front of everyone. Shy means sigupartham. So it was too shy to dance in front of everyone. Now let's read. Prakash the peacock was very shy. He could not dance in front of other peacocks. Tayyate, 1, 2, 1, 2, the teacher counted. So this peacock would go to dance in a dance school. So teacher counted tayyate and 1, 2, 1, 2. So 1, 2, 1, 2 repeated the little peacock. So repeated means, I said earlier itself. Repeated means say again and again. Say again and again. The little peacocks moving the right foot first and the left foot and then the left foot. So the other peacocks also were there. They would repeat with the teacher saying 1, 2, 1, 2, and they would repeat again and again. Okay, and they would move their first right leg, right foot, then the left foot, right left, they would move. Prakash watched them from behind a big thorny bush. Thorny means what? Thorns, having many thorns. Having many thorns. Where do you will find the thorns? Which plant will you find? Yes, the rose plant. You will find in the rose plants the thorns, and some more plants where you will find the thorns. Okay. So he would practice. Practice means do again and again. He would practice behind the thorny bush. The plants where thorns were there, he would hide behind and dance in front of it. He started practicing in his hiding place. So it was a secret place for the Prakash, the peacock. It was a hiding place, and he would hide there and dance, as he was very shy to dance in front of all. Of course, it is not a good idea to practice leaping near a thorny bush. Leaping means jumping. Leaping means jumping. So it is a not good idea. Good idea means you have to be bold enough. You should not be like this shy, because you have to be bold. That is why it is said as it is not a good idea, because you have to be bold. Ouch, ouch, shouted Prakash as he crashed onto a pile of thorny twigs while taking the twist and leap. So ouch means it is the expression showing how what happened. It means, see, when you get hurt or when you fall, you say ouch. That is called ouch. So Prakash, as he crashed onto a pile of thorns. Pile means, again here, this pile means lumpsum. This is a collective noun. This is a collective. Pile means group of thorns. And while twigs, a pile of thorny twigs. Twigs means small sticks, you know, the dried part of the plants, the small thin sticks you will have like this. So this is called the twigs. While taking the twist and leap, what on earth was that noise? The teacher asked. He ran towards the thorny bush. So as he was dancing, Prakash, the teacher could hear some sound, and teacher asked, what on earth was that noise? So what is that noise? The teacher asked, and he ran towards the thorny bush. So the teacher ran towards the thorny bush. Goodness, Prakash, what are you doing here? Why aren't you dancing in the clearing on the soft ground with all other peacocks? The teacher asked. So the teacher went to the thorny bush and seen Prakash. So teacher asked, why are you dancing here? Why aren't you dancing with all your friends there? So the teacher asked. Now the Prakash is speaking. Before Prakash could reply, the other peacocks answered in chorus. See, now chorus means speaking together. We have in singing also, no? The main singer will sing, the others will hide beside. That is chorus. During a song, you can hear the chorus song. So chorus means all speaking together. So the other peacocks, they said in chorus, Prakash can't prance, he can't even talk. All he can do is walk. So the other peacocks were saying that he can't dance, he can't even prance. Now prance means, I'll tell you what is prance. So prance means dance in a particular way. He dances very differently. The other peacocks are saying he can dance only in a different way, particular, peculiar. He can't even dance like we do. The thing he can do is he can only walk. So this is how the Prakash is. So in the next class, we will know what all he has done after these other peacocks were talking about him. So thank you.